تفضل شيخ.
So شيخ, for we understand the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام did not recite the entire Quran 200 times in these 200 different
قراءات. لا لا. In each word he has differences and some of the words repeats in the Quran. So you know that it would be repeated like that. So that work الصراط maybe recited in الفاتحة الصراط and الصراط. But maybe he did not say the word الصراط with a scene any time in the Quran. You understand? But you know, the Qari, he says it is recited here, so it's followed in the Quran like that. So it is like this, يعني.
And one more to confirm your statement. As we go down the chain of reciters from Nafi down the wall to Natsimi, the choices become tighter and tighter.
Yes. Okay. Like for example, Al-Imam Nafi, Qira'ah. That's a Qira'ah, right? And the Qira'ah, it has a lot of variations in it. So you cannot say, I'm going to recite to you now according to Nafi. Bismillah ar-Rahman. Nothing like that. You are not going to be able to. Right? So, okay. Which riwayah? I'm going to recite Warsh. Now it is kind of like half of it is excluded. Half of the variations that Nafi recite is excluded with who? Qanun. Are there other people who recited from Nafi? Yes. But they are not as mutawatir as Warsh and the Qanun. Because Warsh, he make his choices very tight way and then Allah put barakah that he have thousands of students. But out of those thousands of students, he has al-Asbahani wal-Azraq. Tariq, you know? And it stops there. يعني you don't go down. You don't go lower than al-Asbahani and al-Azraq. And you said, oh, al-Asbahani also taught this way and that way. No. So I said, I am going to recite according to Nafi. With the narration of Warsh. With the tariq or the method of al-Azraq. So now I tightened myself. So Nafi, big. Warsh, half. Al-Azraq, half of the half. But within Al-Azraq, I have also choices. يعني within Al-Azraq, I said, الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا or آمَنُوا or آمَنُوا. But if I said آمَنُوا six, means the alif at the end, like Al-A'la, for example, has to be recited in a certain way. But if I said with the قصر آمَنُوا, it has to be مفتوحة. But with the long six haraka, it has to be a qleel. If I do tawassut, I have the option like that. You know, so you choose one, you go. But all of it is called tariq of al-azra. Qalun. Okay, you're going to read qalun. Tariq abin nashit or tariq this or tariq that. So you choose the tariq and within the tariq you have different ways. So qalun, he will say alaykum or alaykumu. Now if there is a hamza after it, if you say alaykumu, are you going to make the mad four haraka or two haraka? So you have four ways within the same tariq. Asim, the one we said, that's easier one, right? Let's say Asim. Now you choose Hafs or you choose Shu'bah. Okay? So you say Hafs and Asim. Now you know that he recites the way we all know and the way the Mus'haf is written, all of that. Hafs, right? Shu'bah is a little bit different than Hafs. Ridwan becomes Rudwan. Huzwa becomes Huzwa. You know, there is different usul and farsh and all of that. But this is minor differences. There are what? Minor differences. But within Hafs itself, what you don't know, there are 28 different ways within Hafs itself. And some of them make it 57 even. يعني different ways. Hafs will read with two haraka in the mad, or three haraka, or four haraka, or five haraka in the munfasil. And in the muttasil, you have four, five, or six. Okay? So now, 4, 5, or 6, with which one? With the 3, 4, or 5. And then you have sakta and hamza, like man, amana, shay'un, right? So he will, if he does that, which mad he choose? So which mad with the sakt and with the ghunna of lam and ra? So ghunna and lam and ra does not come with the sakt. So if you do the ghunna, you have to do certain mad. If you do sakt, you have to do certain mad. With the ghunna of lam and ra, it comes in two haraka, three haraka, four haraka, and five haraka. Okay? So if somebody making jam'a for the riwayah of Hafs, he keep repeating in this maddan sakta al-ghunna, maddan sakta al-ghunna, maddan sakta al-ghunna. And this is actually one brother, Bashir Hussam, he's reciting with me all turuq Hafs together. And it is very fun, mashallah, and it's amazing. Like, you know, he's sitting one ayah, maybe 10 minutes, kida, you know, like he's to recite the whole thing, all the awjah of that. So subhanAllah, this is an amazing effort, يعني. But It's an ocean, you know, it's like the Pacific Ocean, يعني. So when you recite Quran, I don't want you to feel frustrated or feel, no, but I want you to feel little. That's needed, right?
Yeah.
You feel humble. you feel small, like a little child lost in the desert. صحيح. And the only one who God use رب العالمين. I want you to feel like that. And that's actually how I'm feeling. That's actually how my shuyukh taught me to feel. Like when you read in the Quran, never, ever, ever feel that you are a master of the Quran. That's wrong. Who is the master of the Quran? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not anyone else. You didn't have everything. Allah azza wa jalla revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the way and different ways. So every time you see this, you feel like you're in the middle of the ocean. You'll get tired. You need some skills. You need guidance. And you will still swim. Maybe you will not reach until you die. So you keep, all of us will keep learning. So may Allah make us, inshallah. Sheikh Muhammad, if you have any questions, I'm so sorry and I took a long time before. After. The way the 10 narrations are authenticated is the difference from hadith or the same, and do they have similar degree like Sahih Week, etc. Very good question. as I mentioned in the beginning, it is similar in the way it is perceived, the way it is handled to authenticate, to say who is weak and who is strong and all that among the narrators, right? Subhanallah, in the Quran, we don't have like weak narrator, strong narrator like that. All the people of the Quran are people of the Quran. So they will never be accepted unless we know their shiukh. And their shiukh certify them. So that's the only way. It's not like hadith. Yeah, in hadith you say, I heard that hadith from someone. Maybe that someone did not see you hearing this hadith from him. But in Quran you have to actually recite. I have to see you reciting it. You have to be reciting it to me. And I have to say that قَرَأَ عَلَيَّ, he recited with me, خَتْمَةً, whole Quran from cover to cover, كَامِلَةً, all of the things, مُتْقَانَةً, profession, مُجَوَّدَةً, with the ahkam according to the rule, right? مِنْ حِفْظِهِ, from his or her memory, right? And I approve of them, and I told them that I am approved from such a sheikh when I recited. So Sheikh Hussein recited with me. حفص عن عاصم من طريق الشاطبي said قرأ عليه ختمة كاملة مجودة متقنة من حفظه according to the قراءة of عاصم, the رواية of حفص, the method of الشاطبي, right? And I told him that I recited with this specific narration, this specific قراءة among my recitations of the 10 قراءات on that sheikh. And that sheikh recited with 10 قراءات on that sheikh, on that sheikh, on that sheikh. And then we go to الإمام ابن الجزري, الإمام الشاطبي, Imam Abu Amr al-Dani, and then Abu Amr al-Dani recited Hafs on who? Until Hafs, until Asim, Abu Abdurrahman al-Sulami, Uthman ibn Affan, Zayd ibn Thabit, like that, right? So this is how you do. So it's very tight in a way that it has to be from that person to that person to that person. There is no hearing only, right? There is no, here is the qira'ah of Nafi', go teach it. There is no such a thing like that in the Quran, but there is in the Hadith. So in the way that you say there is weak qira'ah or this or that, technically yes, but it's not like the way the hadith is. So when you say weak qira'ah, means abandon, خلاص, out, right? But when we say qira'ah shadha, does not mean weak. It means authentic, as long as it has what? Chain of narration. But it's either not mutawatir, right? So how we use it now? Fuqaha said, can I use a mutawatir ahad qira'ah? Can I do like hadith or not? And then, or it is mutawatir, but not according to the way the mushaf is written. So يعني, it's different from الرسم, but it has sanad, and the sanad mutawatir. Right? So we don't recite it in the salah, but we can use it in the ahkam. That's why in the tafsir, you will find qira'at that you don't know about. You said, and this word was recited like this, and that helps in the meaning. So it can be used. يعني, if it is weak, abandoned all the way. And if it is there, it does not mean we're going to use it in the salah. Right? So, يعني, it has different variety, simple variety. يعني, but it's correct, yeah. Fadal, let him ask.
Shefa, the question I had was like Nafi', you said he taught it to his students like this. What permitted him to teach it a different way? Whereas you said, like, there's.
His shuyukh.
No, but. What restricted the lower of the chain? Like you said, he taught it to one person and he had taught it two other ways, correct? What restricted them? Like, why couldn't they teach it another way after that? Remember you said?
Like, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, Umma, they did. They did.
Oh, they did?
But it did not spread like the way it was before. يعني, Imam Nafi', he taught to thousands of students. right? Why we don't have this chain of the thousands of students? The thousands of students did not make tighter choices like Warshan Qalun.
Oh, okay.
So Warshan Qalun was as proficient as Imam Nafi' to make their own choices from the qira'ah of Nafi'. يعني, there are many things for sure Warsh heard from Nafi', but it is not in his recitation. You understand me? So not like not everything Warsh heard from Imam Nafi' or recited to him, he ended up teaching to his student. يعني he made choices from the totality of what he heard from Nafi'. He said, I'm going to choose those. And the Qalun did the same. Well, the other thousands did the same. But it depends now how they carried it to the next one. Nothing prevented them. Nothing restricted them. But it depends how proficient you are, how sincere you are, and how many students you have.
So if, had they been hypothetically speaking, had they had a student who was more proficient,
yeah,
we would have had an additional
qira'ah. Yes, we would have an additional qira'ah. But it came, like, I think in the, يعني after this 14 qira'ah, and we'll talk about that next time. That gate was closed by scholars,
mm-hmm.
right? They said, you know, we don't have anybody on that caliber anymore,
no.
right? So there is no ijtihad in this anymore. That's it, mm-hmm. right? So what we have is that's it, and all the copies of the Quran started being distributed, so we don't want somebody to start a newer copy with a newer copy with a newer copy, and then, you know, it will defeat the purpose, right? So let's stick with what Uthman ibn Affan did, and we stop there. So no one would... You know, like you keep doing the variations as long as it is in accordance with that. And that limits it actually. After a while, it's limited. You can make all the choices. So, but everybody will make the choice. He has to be restricted by what? What is written here. So they'll become repetitive now, right? Like Imam Khalaf al-Ashir, for example, the 10th. Imam Khalaf هذا, he narrated from Hamza. يعني في خلف عن حمزة. يعني he's a narrator of Hamza. But then he learned from other Qurra too. Hamza wal Kisa'i wa Asim. He recited on other Qurra other than the 10. Okay? Other than the other 9. He recited other than them. And then he make his own choices. So he is reciting with his choices from Hamza. And he make his own choice. But guess what? He never differed independently from anyone. يعني always he's either agreeing with Shu'ba and Asim, with Al-Kisa'i and Hamza, or with Hamza himself. So always agree with someone. But the other 9 Qurra, he might have a difference that no one else has. Right? It's very interesting.
You'd actually answer one of my questions.
Okay.
The second is, are there words in big books of the sea, like Tabari and the word which are more expensive, that have pronunciation that are not found in any of the 14? In other words, are there many descriptions mentioned in from the extinct Qira'at?
Yeah,
okay.
There are.
Even today that we have these books of Tafsir.
Yeah, we have. Yeah, we have the books of Tafsir. يعني مثلا, instead of الحمد لله رب العالمين, الرحمن الرحيم, مالك يوم الدين, or مالك يوم الدين. That encompasses all 10. You have مالك يوم الدين as a verb. يعني he owned the day of judgment. اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, اهدنا صراطا مستقيما. Right? صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم, we have عليهم, we have عليهم, we have عليهم. There is the قراءة الحسن عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. So there are different ways and there are different than that. إن شاء الله يعني this is not the topic. But maybe it is another time as I mentioned. But inshallah, يعني we will talk about it from the perspective of our discussion, aqidah and fiqh. And maybe, subhanAllah, this opens up other things, يعني. Sure. Who knows? Sure. يعني, but I would not, and I'm telling you now so you can hold me to that, I would not teach details of qira'at to other than students of qira'at who recites it. I would not do that. And I'm not going to go and make a lecture and say, let's study qira'at nafi'. And I'm going to give you all the differences and all that without you reciting according to it with me. And I will teach it to you if you are reciting a khatma of Nafa. I will teach you Shu'ba if you're reciting Shu'ba. I will teach you Abu Amr if you're reciting Abu Amr. But I'm not going to give it to you and then you say, oh, that's neat. Let me go and recite that in Isha Salah tonight, inshallah. Some people actually did that and they end up... Some nice people, some good people, some famous people, may Allah Azza wa Jalla reward them for their effort, attempted to teach this, but they don't have the background. They don't have the training. They don't have that. And this is, as I said, is an ocean. You're good, your knee is great, may Allah reward you. You're not criticizing, but that's not how it is done. At least you should have recited this qira'at on the sheikh. So you know this intricacies and the differences. So you know. Because you're going to make mistake for sure. I make mistakes sometimes. See, why we don't make mistake much in tajweed of hafs? Because this is what everybody recites. This environment. If I go to Tunisia, and then I stay there for a while, and only qalun is recited there, I become very proficient in qalun. If I go to Algeria, I become very proficient in warsh. It's a matter of practice. There's two different things. Knowing them for knowledge, reciting them on a sheikh for ijazah, and practicing them. That's three different things. So not everybody who knows is able to teach. And not everybody who knows and recited them on a sheikh is able to practice. Yani, some people they know and they do that. And then, you know, when they come and recite Hamza, they'll make a mistake. Why? Because they are not used to it. And they recited it in a group, in a gathering of al-ashra. Yani, whenever there is a difference, they come and they do the differences. Right? But to recite a whole surah, it needs a level of skill as well. يعني يوم مراز الشاطبية بقى الدرة والطيبة, you know the متون in your head والتحريرات والشيخ, and you recited it and you recite with that. Some شيوخ with the قراءات, they will recite a khatma in, يعني in their word, يعني if I recite the Quran every week, this week I'm going to recite it with Hafs, next week with Shu'ba, next week with Qalun, like that. That makes it actually better to recollect faster, يعني. But this Quran is like an ocean, يعني. So may Allah Azza wa Jal give us more, يعني. جزاكم الله خيرا, وصلى الله على محمد, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.